Hello students of class 10, today I'm going to continue with the rest of the portion of the satellite imagery. So before going to the types of the satellite imagery, let us have a revision of that. So previous thing that the satellite images, imageries are the images which is captured by the some satellites which are orbiting around the earth. This satellites actually use the different kinds of the sensor to collect the electromagnetic radiation which is reflected from the earth, and based on that radiomagnetic radiation it prepares the different images, and we call that images as the satellite images. Okay, we have seen that there are two types of the satellite image. One is a geostationary satellite and another was the polar orbiting satellite. So what are geostationary satellite? The geostationary satellites are those satellite which is orbiting around the earth from west to east direction, and it is moving at the same speed as the earth is moving, and it is flowing over the equator. Okay, and it is present at an elevation of 22,500 kilometer above the equator. Okay, and the polar orbiting satellites, the polar orbiting satellites are the satellites that move in the north to south direction. It is present at an elevation of 800 to 900 kilometer, and it observes the or it captures the earth at one strip of time. Today, I'm going to discuss about the different types of the satellite imagery. So, number one is the visible imagery. Then we have the water vapor imagery and the infrared imagery. So, the first one is the visible imagery. So, what is a visible imagery? The visible satellites that pictures can only be viewed during the day. Since the clouds reflect the light from the sun, on these images, clouds show up as white and the ground is normally gray and the water is dark. The satellite will see the developing thunderstorm in their earliest stage before they are detected on the radar. So, what is it saying? It is saying is that visible imagery are prepared based on the light which is being reflected from the cloud. Okay, as a result of that, what happens in these images, we can find the patches of the clouds as the white, and the color of this image is black and white with the shades of different shades of black and different shades of gray and white. So you can see in this picture, this is a visible imagery. You can see this portion is white is actually showing you the cloud or that are present over this place. That is actually the map of America, North America, and you can see this grayish portion. This gray portion is actually the land body, and this dark black portion is actually showing the water body. Okay, the satellites are used, or it is very much helpful to understand or to see any developing thunderstorm. We can detect this thunderstorm with the help of the radar. Okay, next one is the infrared imagery. So what is the definition of an infrared imagery? Infrared satellite pictures show clouds in both day and the night. Instead of using sunlight to reflect off the clouds are identified by the satellite sensors that measures the heat radiating off them. Okay, the sensors also measures the heat radiating off the surface of the earth. The clouds will be colder than the land and the water, so they are easily identified. The infrared imagery is useful for determining thunderstorm intensity. Strong to severe thunderstorm will normally have very cold tops. So what is it saying is that, like the previous one, which is the visible imagery, it can only be captured or it can only be made during from the radiation that is being collected by the collected from the cloud during the daytime only. But to prepare the infrared imagery, it can be prepared any time of the day and the night. Specifically, no need to be prepared or no need to be captured during the daytime. Measures the heat that is being radiated from the earth's surface to prepare the images. As a result of that different features on the earth's surface has got different amount of it radiate different amount of sunlight at different point of the time. So based on that, it actually differentiate the different features that are present on the earth. So as the clouds are cooler than the land and the water too, so this can be easily identified with because of that. And this imageries are very much helpful to determine any thing on the earth. It can be helpful to determine the thunderstorm intensity, and because you can see thunderstorm is related with the clouds, so the clouds are easily determined with the help of this infrared imagery. If you can see that the concentration of this white patches, like you can see in this image, this is actually the infrared imagery. You can see this, the central portion of this part is excessively the cloudy portion, and the spiral you can see over here. So with the help of this, that we can understand if the thunderstorm, what are the intensity of the thunderstorm is. Because if the and actually clouds are easily determined with the help of this satellite. So if the intensity of the cloud, or if the cloud is forming at a larger intensity, which we can understand with the help of this infrared imagery, because it will show the cloud in this manner, as you can see in this picture. The last one is the water vapor imagery, or the definition is that water vapor satellite pictures indicate how much moisture is present in the upper atmosphere, approximately from 15,000 feet to 30,000 feet. The highest humidity will be the whitest area, while the dry region will be dark. Water vapor imagery is useful for indicating where the heavy rain is possible. Thunderstorms can also interrupt under the high moisture plume. So what is it saying is that the water vapor imagery, or the imagery which is being collected, which show actually the how much moisture is present in the upper atmosphere. If a place is highly humid, or it, where the humidity is very at a greater range, the place will be the whitest in the imagery, and the region which is which lacks in the humidity, it will be darker in the color. Okay, with the help of this type of the imagery, we can indicate where the heavy rain is possible. Okay, so you can see in the picture too, this portion is showing you the extreme whitest portion. So this is actually the region where the humidity is at the highest range, and you can see the dark black portions over here. This black portion is the region where the humidity lacks, so this is blacker or darker in color. So this is all about the different type of the imagery that we found. Now we will go to the topic of topographical map. Okay, so what are the topographical map? The topographical maps are a detailed record of a land area, which by giving the geographic position means actually the latitudinal and longitudinal value, and the elevation for both the natural and the man-made features. Means we can see the elevation of both the land features and the elevation of both the man-made features, like the houses, the parks and everything. Okay, they show the shape of the land, mountains, valley, plains by means of brown color contour line. The lines of the equal elevation is above the sea level. Means we can identify the features or the elevations of any places of this of any places on the earth with the help of some contour lines. I'll be showing you that. And it actually, with the help of that, we can see, or we can identify what type of a feature is present in a particular region. The distinctive characteristics of the topographical map is that it uses the different kinds of the elevations, with means elevation of the contour lines, to show the shape of the earth's surface. The elevation contours are the imaginary lines which connects the points having the same elevation on the earth's surface above or below the reference surface, which is actually the mean sea level. The contours make it possible to show the height and the shape of the mountains and the depth of the ocean bottom and the steepness of the slope. The topographical maps are also show the many kind other kinds of the geographical features too, which is included the roads, railways, rivers, streams, lakes, boundaries, etc. Now let us see the image of a topographical map. This is actually a picture of the topographical map. So you can see the brown lines over here. You can see the curved portions like this. These are actually the contour lines. So these contour lines are being drawn with the help of the points joining the same heights. So you can see that the heights are being also mentioned over here, like the 1350, then 1450. So there is the difference between these two contour of line is 100 meter. So with the help of this, we can identify any physical features that is present on the earth surface. Okay. The topographical maps also contains of the roads, railway lines, etc. The roads and the railway lines and also the settlements are being marked with the help of the red lines and the red dots. And this you can see the green patches. This is actually showing you some of the forested region. And the blue patches over here is showing you the water body or lake body, anything like that. And this is actually the river. River is being showing with the help of the blue color. So this is all about the satellite images and the topographical maps. So this is the end of this video. I'm going to continue with the next portion in the next video. So thank you everybody.